So far in this tutorial series, I launched a free WordPress site on the CloudAccess.net platform and I gave an overview of the WordPress dashboard. We also discussed how to locate, install, and customize themes. It's now time to start creating our own content for the site, but before we do, it's important to understand that WordPress has two basic types of content, which are posts and pages. By default, when we launch a WordPress site, our homepage is a stream of our current posts, and posts consist of blogs, news, or other types of frequently updated content. They're organized by date, author, categories, and tags, and these things we'll discuss in later tutorials, and posts are usually available through an index. Posts also typically contain a commenting area and/or social sharing links. If we open up the Hello World post, which is part of the sample data that comes with our WordPress installation, we can see that it's published with a publication date and an author, and there's also an area to provide comments at the bottom of the post. To contrast this, open up the sample page, which is also part of the sample data that comes with your WordPress installation. Pages are usually permanent pieces of information about the site, like a contact form or an About Us page that you'd like to make available to your site visitors through a menu. Unlike posts, which are organized using categories and tags, pages are organized in parent-child relationships. For instance, we could make a child page of the sample page here, which would appear as a drop-down menu item. Pages don't appear within the blog stream, and they usually don't feature comments or social options, although they may. When you're trying to decide between a post and a page, and you'd like the menu item to appear on the main menu of the WordPress site, it's usually a page. And if you'd like an item to appear within the stream of continually updated items, it's usually a post. Later tutorials in this series will show you how to create both posts and pages. The next tutorial will show you how to create categories for posts to keep your posts organized.